Are you sending thousands of emails through HubSpot but not seeing the results you want? Today I'm going to show you a simple but yet overlooked setting that could dramatically boost your email campaign's effectiveness. So in today's video, we'll dive into a crucial aspect of HubSpot marketing. It's called email authentication. This is something that many overlook, but it's quite essential for your marketing success. So let's get started. So the common challenge that I see is that marketing teams invest heavily in getting those leads into their funnels, using paid ads and everything to collect all these email addresses so that we can send them into an email flow and then nurture them toward becoming a customer, right? But here's the massive challenge. If you haven't set up your HubSpot correctly, maybe 50% of those leads that you're trying to email will never see your emails, or 100% of them could fail because you will end up in the spam folder. Huge, huge challenge. So there's a massive opportunity here by fixing your email authentication because it improves your deliverability of your emails and it creates better engagement with your audience, and ultimately it just creates success for your email campaigns, which in the end, hopefully, should trickle down to some actual revenue and sales, right? So, from my experience, the first thing I do when I go into a new HubSpot account or set one up from scratch is to check if the emails are actually authenticated correctly. It is a massive game changer, and today I'll share with you the exact steps to ensure that your emails are perfectly set up. So, first, many people actually confuse the one-to-one email setup with the marketing email setup in HubSpot. So the one-to-one email setup happens when you connect to your Google account or your Outlook account, whatever, for sequences, for example, or connecting your calendar and so on. This is different. This is for the marketing emails that you would use in one-off campaigns or workflows. And it's really important to distinguish between those two. So yeah, let's continue and let's actually see how this needs to be set up in HubSpot. So the first thing you need to do is log into your HubSpot, of course, and then hit this little wheel up here. And then you scroll down over here and you click on the domains and URLs. And then you, depending on how much you have already done in here, you might see some different domains here and slightly different settings. This is our account. So if I want to send emails from digitalwasabi.dk, our domain, I would hit this orange button over here, connect a domain, and then I would click this one, email sending. That's our purpose. Then I would say christian@digitalwasabi.dk. Great, that's the email address that you can just put in any email address here. Just needs to be something that ends with the correct domain here. Then click the next button down here. It will just double check with you. Emails will be sent out from. Yes, sounds good. If you hit the next button down here, you will get a couple of CNAME records. If you have no idea what that is, talk with what a tech guy. You need to change settings over on your DNS, so your hosting provider, so where's your website being hosted, that's where you need to change these things. So you need to add two CNAME settings to your DNS, and that's just a one-time thing. I have already done that for ours, so if I click next here, I'll just say yeah, it's connected. Boom, 72 hours, everything will you will be good to send emails. So now you can see down here, email sending domains is already showing for digitalwasabi.tk. And we also have a campaign site, Messy Growth Show, our podcast, which is also connected. So remember also to connect it if you have additional domains. Great. So that's the two primary things. And then there's a hidden little gimmick here, which a lot of people unfortunately miss. It's down in the advanced options. something called an SPF record. Now I'll just click copy SPF record, and then you will be like, okay, nothing happened. SPF record looks like this. That's the one I just pasted in. So include, and then it's like our unique URL for us sending emails. So if you're using G Suite like we are, then this is from our DNS. You will have a DNS record, a text one that looks like this. SPF includes google.com, blah, blah, all. And what you want to do is to edit this record here. So you take what I just got from HubSpot, and then you, after here, after google.com, you just paste it in, make another space, make sure that there's space after here, and then all. Then you click update DNS records, and I have cheated a little bit. So before adding it, our SPF record would look like this. And then after I added it, sorry, let's just go back here. Now it looks like this in this tool, mxtoolbox.com, super genius tool for checking that you did things correctly. So now it's showing green all over the place here, check marks all the way down. So I did it correctly. Now both Google can send emails on our behalf and HubSpot can. So far, so good. Then we need to, let's say if you're actually sending emails by the thousands, there's something called DMARC. And it's historically for like high volume senders, but it's just an extra way that you can authenticate your domain. So saying like, we are not spammers. So I have signed up for this call an app or service called postmarkapp.com. I'm just running on their free version here. And if we just look at our settings, I just needed to add a bit more DNS records. And it was fairly simple. So now you can see that we are verified. Everything, if I look up in this MX toolbox, they have one called DMARC lookup, hiding here in this drop down. So if I look how things are, I am also getting the full all good check marks down the page here. So now we are both SPF. SPF is set up correctly. DMARC is set up correctly. We connected the domain in here in HubSpot with the CNAMEs. So now I don't think there's much more we can do to have a more approved domain and not ending up in that horrible spam folders and instead ending up in our prospects inbox. So just to recap it, to authenticate your HubSpot emails, set up your DNS with the SPF and the DMARC records. It's super crucial for email campaign deliverability and just your brand's reputation in the audience inbox. And I encourage you really to do this today. Set it up. Takes 10 minutes if you have access to the DNS. Ensure everything is checked up, is set up correctly. Check it in that MX toolbox. So yeah, and if you're already sending large volumes, seriously consider the DMARC. Also just with low one, it doesn't really take much longer time. So if you want more tips like this, simply write HubSpot down in the comment section, and then we will send you our additional tips on how to use HubSpot even better. Thank you for watching.